Well, that's not gonna work.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. I read mainly YA and MM romance, so if either of those are your cup of tea, then feel free to subscribe or just keep watching. I will preface this video by saying though that this is a YA reading vlog. So if you're here for the MM romance, I'm afraid there's none of that in this video. So I have decided, and truly I don't know why I've decided this really, but I have decided either way that I'm going to try to work my way through my entire physical TBR, most of which is YA fiction. Mainly because I had a very bad habit of buying a shit ton of books, never reading them, then fell down the rabbit hole that was MM romance during COVID and promptly forgot about literally every YA book on my TBR and on my actual bookshelves. So I started this last year and then got very distracted, and honestly it took me like 2 months to finish a book because I just was not having it. So essentially my plan of attack is that every week, every Monday, I'm gonna start a new book that's on my physical TBR. I'm gonna figure out how many pages it has, divide that by 7, and that tells me how many pages I have to read every day to finish this book in a week. I'm kind of terrified. I did do this last month. I ended up reading The Diviners by Libba Bray, which I didn't end up going through with that series just because I wasn't all that interested. And I finally finished the Embassy Row trilogy by Ali Carter because I finished the first one and I was like, you know what? I'm intrigued. So I finished Take the Key and Lock Her Up yesterday, which means I picked my new book. It's not really a new book. I don't get much of a choice. I'm just going in order. So I picked the next book yesterday, which just so happened to be Legendborn by Tracy Dion. I bought this book in 2020 when it came out and then never got around to reading it because I was in my romance hole. But it is time. What's slightly terrifying is that this book has really tiny font and there are 490 pages in this book. You know how many pages that means I have to read a day? 70. Like 70. And I haven't started yet. And it's 8 o'clock on Monday evening. So I'm gonna tackle my 70 pages. I'll give you a little bit of an update. Hopefully there'll be a daily update. Who knows if these vlogs are even gonna like go up in time. This could go up in like 3 weeks and you'll never know the difference. Let's get started. I'm gonna put like a little tab on page 70 so that I know I'm getting close. That is how many pages I have to read today. Are you joking? I love that even though I only have to read 70 pages, this tab is going on page 77 because I cannot stop in the middle of a chapter. Let's get started. I have finished my pages for the day. It is 9:30 at night. I did have a bit of a break for dinner though. So I'm currently on page 77, which is chapter 9 and 15% of the way through the book. I am enjoying it so far. It's definitely intriguing. I must admit the first couple chapters I was like, meh. I'm definitely someone who prefers books that like grip me from the first few chapters. I'm not gonna say that like I was completely drawn into it in the first couple of chapters. I mean, it's taken up to chapter 9 for me to be like, actually, I'm finding this interesting. I am very fascinated. I would like to see where it goes. So I'm actually looking forward to tomorrow. Alrighty, hello again, happy Wednesday. I didn't vlog anything yesterday because I had such a crazy day. I went straight from work to Taekwondo and I tried to read my pages when I got home, but I was so tired and just fell asleep and I kind of have no recollection of what I've read. I don't know how I got here. So I'm currently on page 134 and yesterday I was meant to get to page 149. So I almost made it. That does mean that I have to make up those pages as well as my extra 70 pages today. So I need to read to page 219. And I say read until page 219, but I can't stop in the middle of a chapter. And the next chapter is on page 227. I'm reading almost 100 pages today. Okay, I got distracted by TikTok for a little bit, but I'm back. It is 9 o'clock at night. We're on page 186 and I still have to get to 227. I swear though, if we're gonna get another love triangle, like 100%, Nick is like the boy next door type. He's got the blonde hair, the blue eyes. And then you have Cell, who's obviously the bad boy type. And we know who the main character typically ends up with in those situations, but like, who knows how this one's gonna end. The one thing, and the reason I picked up this camera, is this line. All around me, members brush the pads of their fingers in circles for the shh of approval. And my brain immediately went, are they doing this? Or like, what does that mean? What are they doing? Chapter 23, page 199. Ew. That's kind of gross. For anyone who's read, because I don't want to spoil it, anyone who's read Legendborn, when Cell attacks the hell snake, that's so gross. Chapter 24, page 205. Let's get it. Okay. Okay. Chapter 25, page 217. We're almost there for the day.
Ooh,
part three. Roots. That is where we finish for today. Okay, so we are finishing at chapter 26, which is page 227. Definitely enjoying it so far. It is really picking up from the first few chapters. I feel like in the beginning, there wasn't a whole lot of world building. There was enough that it was slightly confusing in certain sections. Okay, very, very quick vlog update because it is now Friday morning and I'm actually driving up to Benalla with my mum today, so I'm not going to be taking the camera up to vlog. And I worked a really late shift last night, so I didn't have a chance to update you guys either, but I'm currently on chapter 22, which is page 297. I'm excited. I feel like it's one of those books where things are happening, but it doesn't really feel like things are happening, and we're gonna get to the end of the book, and I'm gonna be like, holy shit, how did we get from A to B? Because all these things are happening. We're going through the trials, character revelations are coming out, but at the same time, I'm like, eh. Like, nothing's really taken me by surprise yet. The other thing is that I got a delivery yesterday. I still can't believe I did this. I may have bought the hardcover copy of this book when I found it on Facebook Marketplace, because if I really enjoy it, then I was gonna buy the hardcover anyway, and I thought this was going for so cheap. I literally got this for $15, including the shipping. How could I say no to that? You're probably like, Caitlin, why do you have two copies? I have somehow fallen back into the bad mentality that I want all of my books in hardcover. So, lovely. Hello and happy Saturday. I feel like I've had such an unproductive day today, and it's not even I haven't been productive, but I've spent the whole day reading, so I'm kind of fine with it. It's I've been so unproductive and got distracted on TikTok and scrolling through Instagram reels for such a long time that I actually kind of feel bad about it. But anyway, back to my Legendborn pages. I can't actually remember what I last updated you guys on, but I'm currently on page 375, chapter 41. We have just started part four, which is called Splinter. The fact that it's almost 10 o'clock at night and I haven't actually started reading my pages yet, I'll keep you guys posted. I think I'm just gonna do a time lapse for these pages and see how long it takes me to get through this. Chapter 43, page 393. I feel like that was a long chapter. Chapter 44, page 399. Chapter 45, page 406. Things are getting interesting. Why am I freaking out right now? I don't know what's about to happen. Surely not. I don't think you're allowed to do that, person.
Okay, so my battery's flashing that my camera's about to die, but I'm currently up to chapter 46, which is page 416. I'm gonna keep reading until I hit my 70 pages for the day. I know I said, I think it was yesterday, that this book isn't really exciting me all the time, and that still hasn't changed. There are some chapters that I'm reading and I really just want to skip through till we get to something a little bit more exciting. And I know that books can't be exciting all the time, but like, you want to be drawn in by what you're reading through the whole book.
Okay, I'm finally jumping back in. My camera died and it is officially the next day. It is Sunday evening. I'm actually about to go to bed and figured I'd better wrap up this video. So after my camera died and I said I was going to finish reading my 70 pages, I ended up finishing the book. Like, that was the climax of the story, was right when my 70 pages were up. And I was like, there is not a chance in hell I'm putting this book down and waiting until tomorrow. I'm finishing this today. I feel like throughout this vlog, I've had so many mixed feelings about this book. There have been times where I was a little bit bored and I just kind of wanted to flick through to the next part. And then there were chapters where I could not put it down for the life of me. I was so intrigued that I just had to keep reading. And I feel like for that reason, I gave it a 4-star rating out of 5. There was also the fact that throughout this whole book, I felt a little bit disconnected. And I don't know if that's just because it's been so long since I've read a YA fantasy that, you know, I can't connect to them as easily as I used to be able to. But I did feel while reading this book that I was kind of looking at it from a distance. Like, and I get that that's exactly what we're doing. We're reading words on a page, but when you really have that book that you love and that you can sink into, it doesn't feel like that. It feels like you're actually there with the characters. You're so absorbed in the world. And I didn't quite have that connection with this one. I felt like the plot, the characters, the romance even, we were all just kind of, or at least I felt like I was kind of reading it from back here rather than here where I wanted to be, you know? I feel like that doesn't really make a whole lot of sense, but it does in my head. Either way though, I am still definitely going to pick up book 2. I am very keen to see where it goes. I did see a review somewhere though that it ends on a hell of a cliffhanger, and I do not know if I'm mentally prepared for that. I do have the book though. I borrowed it from my library, from my work, where I will be finishing up next week. That is so weird. So book 2 is Bloodmarked, which I will be reading in the next vlog to come out. I don't know when that will be, but it'll be this book that I'm reading. I figure though that at the end of this vlog, I will go through and figure out what my daily page count will be. So without spoiling it for myself, this book has 551 pages. Are you joking? That's even more than book 1. I'm reading 78 pages a day, which, look, it's not that much extra. It's only an extra 8 pages. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this reading vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to let me know down below your thoughts. Let me know what you're reading at the moment. Give me any recommendations. I am open to it all. But also feel free to give this video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button down below if you'd like to see similar content. I have quite a few videos that I'm like in the middle of filming and editing at the moment, and the editing process is taking such a long time. I forgot how arduous that process can be sometimes. But hopefully I can have a few more videos up for you shortly. But in the meantime, hope you enjoy this and I will see you in my next video. Bye.